I'll show you how to make a bicycle third hand that you can use in adjusting your brake. If you're adjusting your brake, you have to hold this to maintain the distance of the brake pads from each side of the wheel. And then while holding this, you have to loosen this and then pull the cable with your pliers or long nose and then tighten this with the number 10 wrench. The problem is you need three hands. One hand to hold the caliper, the second hand to pull the cable, and then the third hand you tighten the bolt. That's why it's called bicycle third hand or bicycle fourth hand. So this is a device you can easily make. So you can adjust this to make the distance in the manner you want. The problem with this is that while you're adjusting the cable, this usually falls down. This falls on the floor. So to keep it in place, you need two. The first one, you need to place two wooden parts. So you drill holes and then insert it in your clamp in this manner. And then attach this one here. I'll show you. I'll just put the camera down for a while. So the setup is like this. One clamp holds the two pieces of wood that is attached to this portion of the second clamp. So this now will be prevented from falling down. So if you can see, you can just loosen this one and then you can squeeze the caliper to the distance you want by just moving this one. See? Okay, so now while it is in that position, you now pull the cable and then tighten this. So this is one DIY project you can have as a third hand for adjusting your brakes. Now there's one I invented which also has the same purpose, but this is about 300 pesos. You need two, so that's 600 pesos. There's a cheaper alternative, a cheaper DIY third hand. I'll show you how it looks like. So this is the bicycle third hand I invented. So this is just an ordinary L bracket for making bookshelves. I just cut it here. This I place in my car when I'm cycling outside, and this one I usually keep in my bicycle workshop. So I just place this is 5 inch, the length is 5 inch, the size is 1/4 inch. This is barrel, this is a bolt with an hexagon head, and then just use a butterfly nut here. On the lower portion, you need to bolt these two. This is the head. You have another bolt here, just like here, so this won't move. So this side moves left and right. This one also, you place a butterfly nut here and a butterfly nut there, because sometimes you want to place it, you want to place this portion somewhere here. So this has to be adjustable. Now this portion you place on your brakes, and then if you want to tighten the caliper, just tighten this. If you want to spread your caliper, just loosen this and your caliper will spread again. Once you've determined the position you want, just so the bracket will be here, and then once you've determined the position you want, just pull the cable and then tighten it with your, so you pull the cable with your pliers and then tighten the nut here with your number 10 wrench. So I'll show you how it looks like when placed here. So when placed there, it looks like this. So if you want to tighten the caliper, just turn this butterfly nut and it will squeeze the caliper to the distance you want from the two edges of the rim. So if you want to increase the distance, you just loosen it and the caliper will open like that. If you want the caliper to be tight or to be nearer the rim, the two sides, just turn this and it will go like that. So here, so if I tighten it, take a look at that, this portion of the brake pad, this one. So if I tighten it, so look that if I tighten it, the brake pads will go near the rim. See? If I want to loosen it, I just loosen it this way. So take a look at that, the brake pad. Tighten it, it will go near the rim. If I want to loosen it, see, it spreads. Now, if I'm satisfied with the position of the brake pads on the left and the right, so I just pull this cable and then tighten it. So my left hand will pull the cable, my right hand will tighten the bolt here. So that's the use of this bicycle third hand which I invented. You can easily copy that. This is again an ordinary piece of bracket. I just cut it here so that there will be some sort of clamping mechanism like that. So that's it. Now if you want to remove it, just turn this and then you can ease it. If you want to place it, just place these two ends somewhere here and then tighten it. As you tighten it, the calipers will go nearer the bicycle rims, the left side and the right side of the bicycle rim, so that you can easily adjust your brakes. You can also use this in V brakes. Okay, so that's it.